Hi there and welcome to another video from Hegarty Maths. It's Mr. Hegarty here, and in this video we're talking about substituting and solving. Why are we doing this? This is going to be a key skill in the forthcoming skills about solving simultaneous equations. That's the main reason we're doing it. This little skill is going to be so useful to us, so it's really, really worthwhile. Let's start by linking to things we already know. Previously on Hegarty Maths, you would have solved something like this. Pause the video and double check you can do that. Okay, if I got something like this, the first thing I'd probably do is I'd probably write the variable on the left-hand side, and at the same time I'd probably swap the order of this addition because addition is commutative. So my first line of working, I'd probably write 3y add 10 is equal to 19. I just like my variable on the left, and I also, that just is neater for me. Then I would undo the add 10 by subtracting 10 from both sides, and I would get myself 3y is therefore 19 take away 10, which is 9. Then I'd divide both sides by 3, and I'd get myself that y is therefore 9 divided by 3, which is 3. I check it before I went on. 3 times 3 is 9. 10 add 9, 19. Yes, I got it right. And hopefully you did too. Now I want to show you this type of thing, which is the thing we're going to be trying to do in a second. We have talked about substituting into a formulae before, so do go back to that if you're not sure. But imagine someone told you, given r is 2x add 3y, find y when x is 5 and r is 19. We're told r, we're told the value of x, and we can substitute them in. So let's do that. R is 19, so instead of r, I'm going to write 19 here. And I'm going to say that's equal to 2, that means 2 multiplied by 5. I usually put the 5 in a bracket like that, just to remind me to multiply it. Plus, we're not given any information about y, 3y. So therefore, 19 is equal to 10 add 3y. Anything familiar to you guys? Well, look, that's the very equation we solved at the start, where we found that y ended up being 3 after a bit of work. And this is the type of skill I need in this video. I need you to be able to substitute into a formula and find one of the other variables. Okay, so in this case, can you see just by the one extra step of substituting, you convert it into an equation you know how to solve, and then you can find y. So this is the thing we're going to be doing in this video. But as you can see, it's just solving equations, guys, but there's an initial step of substituting in. Let's get going and try some. Pause the video and have a go if you think you can do this. Given that r is equal to 8x add 3y, find x this time. We're asked to find x when y is 5 and r is 19. So r is given to us as 19, this here. Y is given to us as 5, so we're going to substitute that in here. And then we're going to write our equation. So we're going to write that 19 is therefore equal to 8x, we've got no information about x, so we're just going to write 8x add 3y. So I'm going to say add 3 brackets, I'm going to put in y in a bracket to remind me to multiply. If I didn't have the bracket, I might think that looked like 35. So let's do that. That's 19 is equal to 8x add 15. Now I like to write my x's and my variables on the left hand side. I'm just going to swap these round. I just find it neater like that. 8x add 15 is equal to 19. To undo the add 15, I'm going to subtract 15 off both sides, and I'll get myself the line that 8x is therefore equal to 19 subtract 15, which is 4, and then I'm going to divide both sides by 8 to cancel that, multiply by 8 there, and I get myself that x is 4 over 8. I can't write 4 over 8, I've got to simplify it, divide top and bottom by the highest common factor of 4 and 8, which is 4, I'd get x is a half. And there you go, I found x when y was 5 and r was 19. I can put in a half here, and I could put back in 5 here and check I get r is 19. 8 times a half is equal to 4, 3 times 5 is equal to 15, 4 add 15 is 19, yep, that works, and I'm done. Right, next one. Now this time, we're given a number on this side, but it's not a variable. We're just asked to find y when x is 2, So we can substitute into and find what y is, and find y when x is negative 1. So pause the video and try that. So I'm going to state that 7 bracket 2, substituting in 2 here, take away 3y must equal 11. So that's 14 take away 3y is equal to 11. To undo that positive 14 here, I'm going to subtract 14 off both sides. And I'm going to get myself that negative 3y is therefore 11 take away 14, which is negative 3. And I'm going to divide both sides, not by 3, but by negative 3, to get myself the answer, y is equal to 1. And I could just double check it. If I put 1 in here for y, let's say, and put x is 2 in here, 7 2s are 14, 3 1s are 3, 14 take away 3, 11, I know I got the right answer. And I'm done. Next one here, exactly the same thing, but you substitute in negative 1 for x. So I'm going to say 7 bracket negative 1 take away 3y is equal to 11. So this is therefore negative 7 take away 3y is equal to 11. To undo negative 7, I'm going to add 7 to both sides. And I'm going to get myself that negative 3y is therefore equal to 18. And as before, I divide both sides by negative 3 to cancel that, multiply by negative 3. And therefore, I get myself that y is therefore positive 18 divided by negative 3 is negative 6. And if I substitute in here negative 1 here and negative 6, trust me, I get 11. So you can check that. You can say 7 multiplied by negative 1 is negative 7. 3 multiplied by negative 6 is negative 18, and you're taking them away. Negative 7 take away negative 18, negative 7 add 18, you get 11, and I've checked it, and I'm right. Okay, last one for you to try. Do pause the video and have a go here. Now this time we're given what y is and we're asked what x is. So let's substitute in y is 3 into here. I would get myself 7x take away, and I'm going to write 3. I'm going to substitute in y here is the value 3. So 3 bracket 3 equals 11. 7x therefore take away 9 is equal to 11. I'm going to add 9 to both sides to undo that, subtract 9. And I'm going to get myself 7x is therefore equal to 11 add 9, which is 20. I'm going to divide both sides by 7, and I'm going to get myself the answer that x is equal to 20 over 7, and I'm done. And if I was doing it in the case where y is negative 2, same thing, I would just say 7x take away 3 bracket negative 2, I'm going to put in for y, is equal to 11. 7x, now I'm going to think of this as negative 3 multiplied by negative 2, which is actually positive 6, and negative multiplied by negative is positive, and that's 11. And then I'm going to subtract 6 off both sides to undo that, add 6, and I'm going to get myself that 7x therefore is equal to 11 subtract 6, which is 5. And to undo that multiply by 7, I'm going to divide both sides by 7, and I'm going to get myself the answer x is therefore equal to 5/7. And we're done. And this skill is going to be crucial in the upcoming skills of solving simultaneous equations. So make sure you're super good at that before moving on. That's it for now. Thanks for watching.